How's it going, my dudes? I hope you guys are having a fantastic week. For today's video, we will be discussing some truths you guys need to know when deciding to become an architect. So first, how do I become an architect? It's pretty straightforward in most countries. First, you have to go through 5 years of architecture school or college. Then after you graduated, you have to go through 2 years of apprenticeship where you work under an architect or mentor. Make sure you apply in a company or firm that has an architecture design department, or better yet, you should apply in an architectural firm. So after the 2 years of apprenticeship stage, you now will go on to take your licensure examinations to become a legit architect. So in other countries, this is a difficult process and takes years. Luckily for me, here in the Philippines, it is quite straightforward. So you take the exams that include all the things you studied in school and the things you learned during your apprenticeship. And if you pass the exams, boom! Congratulations, you are now a registered and licensed architect. And that's pretty much how you become an architect. But just like all great things, it is really not as simple as it made it sound like. You're going to need specific skills to become an architect. So to become an architect, you need to be good at drawing, problem solving, and using the computer. You have to be decent at math and logic too. But most importantly, you need to be creative. Now, I understand most of you guys don't have these skills, but luckily, these skills could be developed, and with hard work, anyone can be amazing at drawing and problem solving and even math. Unbelievable! Also, I have a video on how to develop the skills. I'll put the link down in the description or a link up here somewhere on the screen right now. Anyways, self-promotion aside, most of you guys ask if it is an easy course. Well, the truth is, architecture school and the practice of architecture in general is pretty hard. You often stay up late working on designs, you will spend a lot of time doubting yourselves, and you will always have to step out of your comfort zone. But you know, that is where growth is. You grow and improve whenever you step outside your comfort zone. And with growth comes future success. It may feel like it's not leading to anything right now, or you're just wasting your time drawing in the wee hours of the night while your friends are partying or sleeping. You might not notice it, but slowly but surely, you're improving, and it is these little improvements that will someday accumulate and make you successful. I don't know why I had to make a thumbs up. It's awkward now. Anyways, you might see all these overnight successes, but I guarantee you guys, before that overnight success, those people have been working their butts off every day, slowly improving. So if you're out there having a hard time in architecture school or in the architecture field, just do your best and keep on drawing into the night. It's all part of the process, guys. Oh boy, I got really inspirational back there. Anyways, let's move on to the next truth about architecture. Monies. So how much does architecture school cost, and how much do architects make? Now, this is a very complicated question since architecture schools and architecture practices vary in each country. But I will try to answer it in ballpark values the best I can. So yes, architecture school is expensive, especially your first year, because you need to buy a ton of drafting tools like a drafting table, and even a laptop to use for architectural softwares, and you know, watching anime for whenever you get stressed from architecture school. So yeah, prepare your wallets for the first years of architecture school. But you know, enough of those expenses, let us move on to how much does an architect make. I'm gonna be honest, some architects make good money, I mean a lot of money, and some make meh, you know. So for architects who are working in an architecture firm overseas, in rich or developing countries, those guys make $25 to $75 per hour depending on their position in the company. So if you're a draftsman, you will make $25 per hour. But if you're an integral part of the design team, well, cha-ching. Oh man, my voice is still not back. Okay, now let's say you're self-employed. Now what this means is you design buildings for clients and you are basically like a freelancer. So in average, you could get 7 to 10% of the total estimated project value. So to make it simpler, for example, a client asks you to design a house worth $10 million. You are entitled to 10% of that $10 million. That is like a $1 million design fee. Now, this may sound super exciting, but there's a ton of responsibility that comes with being a self-employed architect, like designing and making the working drawings, making sure it passed all of the laws, and making sure your design is being implemented. That means visiting the site daily. You also have to coordinate with the contractor and the owner, and in some cases, you would have to manage the site. So that is why the fee of these freelance architects are so big. Also, getting a client to agree to this fee is super hard, but I will leave that for another video. So yeah, there you go. That is how much an architect makes. But take note, these are all based on my experience, so your mileage may vary on your country and your existing conditions. So don't make this a basis. This is more of a general idea on what you as an architect could make. Okay, let's move on to the last truth for today's video. Now, I know this is going to be super controversial. A lot of you may get mad at me for this, but you are not yet a true architect unless you answer this question on your own terms. What is architecture? Let's say that you have the license and a plaque saying you're an architect, but if your answer to that question is architecture is the art or practice of designing and constructing buildings or something similar, well, you are quite not there yet, because that is the answer that will come up if you search Google for what is architecture. Okay, so your answer could be as simple as architecture is people, or for me, architecture is a bridge that connects people to a place, or it could be something weird like architecture is heart plus rock. Okay, so it might be something weird like that, but as long as it is your philosophy that you apply throughout all of your designs, then you are an architect. Now, your answer to this question could change, and trust me, it will. As long as you continue to improve yourself, you will have a different answer to this question throughout time. And that's fine. Architecture is an ever-evolving art form that changes throughout time. So if you still don't have an answer to this question, don't worry, you guys will get this answer in time. We all have different time frames, so don't try to rush it. To be honest, my answer to this question is still, you know, kinda. Anyways, I'm still working on it. So for those of you who have an answer to what is architecture, leave it down in the comments below. I would love to see your guys' philosophy. I'd like to see your philosophies. And with that being said, I'ma end the video right here. Leave a sub down below if you like this video, and don't forget to share this video to make the Archi Squad community even bigger. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I will see you on my next video. Fly in peace.
One, two, three, four.